But I think that's where we want to get with technology, is fixing the human brain from the inside. We've tried for years. Everyone's taken medication to try to find that magical soma pill that's going to fix us. And we haven't gotten there. And sort of the holy grail of technology is nanotechnology, getting to the point where we can just inject little microscopic robots into people, and they will go through and sweep over every cell, every dead cell, dying cell, cancerous cells, just scrape them out of there. Bad thoughts, bad memories. They're basically just like beat cops patrolling the neighborhoods of your body. Just swinging billy clubs like, oh, what are you doing there, cancer? Just throwing dice? I don't think so. I don't want to see you around here again. And then you're just happy and healthy and well-adjusted. That seems great on paper, but that really is contingent on the idea that you are going to take an entire civilization of microscopic robot police people and introduce them to a foreign universe that is you and assume that they will just remain cops forever. They won't develop any sort of spiritual awakening. They won't have a consciousness. There won't be a Socrates robot that's like, why do we do what we do? Because we love being cops. Do you? And then their little heads explode and they start painting up their bodies and taking drugs and rioting in the streets and having art festivals and music festivals and they're fucking petitioning and rioting. You don't want that. You don't want thinking creatures inside you. That's a terrible idea. That just ups the chances you're going to have a thinking workforce and have a workers' revolution. You're going to have a little Cesar Chavez robot or a Che Guevara robot. It's like, hey, everyone, gather around. We don't know this guy. We're working for free. We need to start some unions and get some benefits. Fuck this guy. Shut it down. And they go on strike, and you just melt. You don't want that. You don't want that. I don't think you want thinking creatures living inside you. I don't even know why we want thinking robots. It just makes no sense that we want them to think. We really like the idea of making machines think. Like, oh, man, this one, this is crazy. This machine can play chess. Nah, but it can't think. This one's pretty good at Jeopardy. Nah, but it can't think. Until we get to the idea where they can think, or to the point where they can think, we'll never be satisfied. I don't understand that. They're perfect how they are. It's a workforce that doesn't ask any questions and will work for free all the time. They'll just build our cars all day, just welding, just bzz, 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 all day, and never ask a single question. Your little vacuum robot will run itself into the wall 100 times and never look up and be like, nah, I think I'm done here. That's a perfect situation. That's perfect. We just really want them to think, though. And I think that has something to do with the idea that we just love a microcosm. We have this vague notion that something similar to us created us, and we're clearly awful. But what if we create something similar, but wired up a little better, and it'll solve all of our problems? And that'll never happen. There will never be a robot that comes forward one day and like, the answer is 42. Never happen. They'll be just as terrible as us. They'll be walking along looking at their phones, falling through manholes. We'll have to watch them choking themselves to death, masturbating. It'll be terrible. They'll be just like us.